speakers. But to start us off, I'm pleased to invite Professor Yedidia Stern, President of JPPI.
Shalom, everybody. Welcome. So many familiar faces and some unfamiliar, so hopefully we'll become familiar. We would like to talk today about what might be the most important issue on our public life. What is the difference between a Jewish and democratic state and just a democratic state? Put it very simply. In what way we are, we should be, maybe we shouldn't be, unique. That's the issue. The idea of the book came from Ben-Gurion. How come? He's already for many, many years in Sde Boker, you know, above Nachal Tzin. Well, in the 50s, when the issue was who is a Jew for the purposes of the law of return, Ben-Gurion came up with the following idea. He approached 50 of Chachmei Israel from Israel and from outside of Israel, from abroad, and asked them, what do you think should be the definition of a Jew for the purposes of the law of return? Not is what is your opinion about who is a Jew, but what should be the definition by the state itself. Well, he got 50, or less than 50 answers. He asked 50, got almost 50. It's published in a book if anybody's interested. The majority of the answers were based on the orthodox interpretation of halacha. Doesn't matter, this is not the issue. But then Chaim Zicherman, where are you, Chaim? Chaim, here you go, Chaim Zicherman, came to me years ago and said, why don't we do the following? Echo Ben-Gurion's idea, but ask a different question. What is a Jewish state? And since this is the 75th anniversary of the state, let's ask not 50, but 75 smart, engaged, intellectual doers. Give us your idea. What is a Jewish state? Think about it. When you try to talk to your kids about what is a Jewish state and you ask yourself, what do they hear? Usually they hear what's on the media. What's in shul, what's in the civic class, they don't have the space, the time to hear a serious answer to this serious question, but the plurality of opinions should be part of it. So we wanted to fix this lack, and we created a team, a winning team. Chaim and myself, we approached Aharon Barak. And I remember the conversation with him years ago saying, Aharon Barak, everybody knows you are for democratic state. What is your opinion about Jewish state? Can you please join for a project when you will be signed on the project explaining different views about the Jewish state? It took a while, but he joined. Then actually, I must tell you, because it's emotional for me, we approached the Supreme Court President Miriam Naor, Zichrona Livracha. She used to be a member of JPPI, but God took it to be with him. And we approached Professor Yehuda Reinhardt to be representative of the Jewish Arts of Israel on this issue. Yehuda, as you probably know, is a historian. He used to be for many years the president of Brandeis University, and now he's president of Mandel, and he joined it happily, and the three of us started the journey about 2 years ago or so. And we collected 75 essays from different people, different views, including those who say, Jewish state, this is illegitimate. Israeli Arabs are writing in the book. People who are Haredim, ultra-Orthodox, are writing in the book. All walks of life, all kinds of opinions are there in this book, and you're very welcome to read. We celebrated the Hebrew version around Yom HaAtzmaut, and now we're celebrating the English translation. Soon enough, there'll be the Chinese one. I'm joking. So you're welcome to come again and again. when we have a chance to publish it in different languages. Now talk only just the beginning of discussion. What are the issues? What is the intellectual challenge to answer the issue of what is a Jewish state? The image I have in my mind, it's like taking a diamond and looking into it. This is my life. The Jewish and democratic state, this is my life. This is a diamond. Now I can look at it from a cultural point of view, and I can see all the duality between Western liberal approach and Jewish traditional approach, and the contradiction, and what is not a contradiction between the two. It's one angle. I turn it a little bit, and I see the national aspect of our life, not the cultural, the national. And then comes to my mind the 20% who are not Jews, but are citizens of the State of Israel. And half of the Jewish people who are part of the nation, but not citizens, those who are not here. How do you reconcile these tensions? And then I turn the diamond a little bit more, and I see the religious aspect of it. Personally, I'm an Orthodox. I understand not everybody is Orthodox. What does it really mean? What are the expression of religion in this public sphere? Should we go by the separation between religion and state or not? And if not, in what way? So each one of us can look at this diamond and turn it around and ask himself, herself, many, many questions about the meaning of a Jewish state. Now, as some of you may know, I'm very much involved in the last 8 months. It took over my life, what's going on in the public sphere in Israel. That's what I do. And the rest of it is unfortunately a footnote right now. Because we feel, all of us, we feel that right now Israel is experiencing a major, major social, political, constitutional crisis. The expression of the crisis is a legal issue, but it's obviously not the essence of it. If I have to say one sentence, what is the essence of the dilemma? Why people are so unhappy? You know, some people came out from their home today to be outside here in the heat. Hopefully we'll not hear them. But kol hakavod to them. They care. I don't want them to shut our mouths. But kol hakavod to them. You have to understand. It's very emotional to all of us. But behind all of this is the question of the book. What do we mean by a Jewish state? One can translate every aspect of the dispute into the question of what is the meaning of a Jewish state. That's why I feel, I mean, obviously we didn't know it will happen when we started the project, but I think reading the book might give each one of us insight, I hope, into many options of understanding the meaning of a Jewish state for our age. I want to finish by saying the following. Usually, you know, we professors, we write a book, we put it on the shelf, and we go to the other book, or not. This project, for us at JPPI, is just the beginning of the journey. It's not that we finish, we have a book in two languages, and that's it. Whoever wants can read and finish with us. No way. We are very much committed to think about the book and the content of the book, the 75 perspective, as the beginning point of a journey, of a discussion. Discussion about the content of the book, and we're going to digitize it, and we're going to do many more of the byproducts from the book, and we see it as a platform for enriching, enhancing, maybe explaining the meaning of our life as a Jewish and democratic state. So thank you for coming, and Yaakov will handle it from here. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.